because of us that hospitals exist in the first place. Physicians and hospitals bill according to what physicians do, surgeries, testing, whatever. Nurses get, the hospital charges for nursing, it's part of the room rate. And yet we're the ones who are tasked with 24/7 responsibility for taking care of these patients, for monitoring and doing assessments and picking up on subtle changes so that we can do something about it before they become raging issues that change the outcome. So we're the revenue producers. Nurses are the revenue producers. Never forget that. Not the doctors, not the hospital. Patients could come to the hospital as long as there are nurses. When I first started in nursing, when I was a student nurse, mandatory licensure didn't hit this state until about 1968. So as a second-year student, I could work in the hospital on the weekends, make extra money. Minimum wage was $1.25 an hour back then, by the way. And I was the closest thing a lot of nights on the weekends to a nurse. I was the closest thing. There was no RN there. I was it. Once mandatory licensure hit, the supervisor would say, make a list of all the drugs you have to sign out, like narcotics and sleeping pills and such, and I'll come up at the end of the shift and sign them out. So we've been used and abused from the very beginning to cut down costs and labor costs, and but we take care of the patients. Thank God back then patients weren't as sick as they are now. I have seen it go from, we had no ICUs, very few around here. We didn't have patients who were too sick because they all died. We didn't have the extended care that we have now. People were in the hospital in traction for low back pain, that kind of stuff. I've seen it transform from that to being critical illness, patients with multiple IVs, multiple machines, multiple drugs, multiple treatments, and you add too many patients to one nurse and it's an impossible situation. So if something happens to one of these patients, guess who's left holding the bag? It's the nurse. It's the nurse's license that's at risk. It's the nurse that the hospital holds responsible. We have to band together. We have to start standing up and speaking up. And when I say speak up, I don't mean be confrontational, be nasty, be rude, but just say, wait a minute, this isn't right. This needs to be done, or that needs to be done. But I've heard so many nurses over the years in all the hospitals I've worked in, they stand and wring their hands and say, oh, but I'm afraid I'll get fired. So what? There is multiple options. You'll never be without a job. It may not be the job you want or the shift you want or the specialty you want, but you can always work. And now our young nurses are going off and traveling, and they don't have to get involved with management or any of their mess. You know, they just can move on. But patients are the ones that are left in the lurch, and we have to take care of patients. Besides standing up for ourselves, and it's starting to rain, there's another thing that we can do and should do, and that's foreign unions. I'm a member of National Nurses United, have been since 2010. I have been retired for almost 8 years, and I still represent them on the AFL-CIO Regional Labor Council at the direction of our president, Ron Reisner. And I can tell you that things in a unionized environment are much better than they are in a non-unionized environment. You're safe to speak. You're safe to make change. You're safe to stand up for yourself and your patients. And after all, that's what we're here for, isn't it? Is to take care of our patients and do what's best. The research has been done and repeated several times that by Linda Aiken and others, that any on a med-surg floor, any patient, anytime you add more than 4 patients to their load, the mortality rate goes up 7%. So if you have 5 patients, it's 7%. If it's 6 patients, it's 14%, and so on. And that's because you can only do so much and you can only be so many places. So please, I beg you, beg nurses in this community, stand up for yourself. Tell the hospitals that you're done being the scapegoat and being blamed. Don't listen to the fact that there's not enough nurses. There's plenty of nurses. We got 4.3 million nurses in this country. They just won't come and work at the bedside because they're tired of being beaten up. So please, stand. stand up for yourselves and let's get together and make this move forward and make it a better place. Thank you.